Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So this is a reaction video. I'm going to be watching a video, and as I'm watching, it's going to record me. And I'm just going to commentate and react to it as I go along. I've already watched the first half of it, but then because it's after the first, like, after 8 minutes or so, I realized, oh, this would be a good video to just kind of do a reaction blog like this. So that's what I'm doing. I think this is a pretty interesting and even, I'll go even so far as to say it's an important video. I think it's really good to react to this kind of video. It is very interesting. Anyway, the link to the video is in the description. It's on the channel, Attacked by Tolerance, and that channel only has this one video uploaded so far. It was uploaded a year ago on May 1st, 2012. The title of the video is Attacked by Tolerance, --how same-sex marriage, in quotes, hurts people. So Attacked by Tolerance, --how same-sex marriage hurts people. And I guess you can watch it with, or you can watch it with me as I react to it, or whatever. You can watch it first and then come back here and see me react. I don't know how you want to do it, or just watch me react to it, but you won't see the actual video footage. But in case you're watching with me, I will just kind of, there will be moments where I pause the video. So when I pause the video, I'll say pause. And then when I resume, I'll count down to three. I'll go 3, 2, 1, and then continue watching the video and react to it. So before I start, I mean, this is a video, it's like a documentary, although sometimes it feels like propaganda material, but it is about the volunteers of the group, and the group is American Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property, or TFP for short. So, that said, let's begin. 3, 2, 1, play. Oh, a bell ringing. That's ominous. Attacked by Tolerance. I like how tolerance is in rainbow, that word, that's...
This
footage nice touch.
Shows how volunteers with Tradition, Family, and Property were attacked for supporting traditional marriage. In this video, you will see TFP volunteers being assaulted, threatened, pepper sprayed, hit with glass bottles, sprayed with pesticide,
nice.
Punched, and spit on.
Spoiler alert.
And their literature was stolen, ripped, and burned.
That's everything that's going to happen in this
video,
by the way.
But before we see this shocking footage, please know that whenever TFP volunteers organize rallies, their conduct is peaceful and respectful.
Of course.
Never aggressive.
Never aggressive.
And our
I'll take your word
positive.
For it.
The banners and signs say, God's marriage equals one man and one woman, or honk for traditional marriage.
Pause. Their message is positive. That's according to them. That's... I don't agree with that, but okay. Fine. That's what they're doing. TFP volunteers go out in the streets having the sign... it's interesting that they wear this red kind of cape over them. Don't really know what that means. That maybe signifies the denominations they're in. I think they're Catholic. I don't know. The signs they have are pretty basic. It's just regular black, red, or blue marker. Just, you know, handwritten on a sign. It's very basic. It's like this, there's no fanciness to it. You know, I would expect much better out of a sign like that, if you're going to go out there. It's a little better than a homeless person's sign, because it's not a cardboard box cutout, but it's pretty crude, basic. Anyway, just wanted to mention that. Let's continue in 3, 2, 1, play.
Those who disagree, however, are not always peaceful.
Of course, that's to be expected, I suppose.
The advocates of same-sex marriage not only dislike the idea of true marriage, but they attack the messenger.
That's a generally overgeneralized statement.
Marriage, please send this video to your friends. More Americans need to see how the homosexual movement attacks the sanctity of marriage and threatens freedom of speech.
Pause. More Americans need to see how the homosexual movement is not tolerant. I mean, what? Wait, you're generalizing the entire pro-gay rights marriage just because of the attacks that happened? Yeah, that's a generalization there that I don't necessarily agree with. But let's continue. In 3, 2, 1, play. Oops, play. Sorry.
Will CNN and MSNBC run this footage? Probably not. So maybe. Please share with your friends.
I haven't seen it, so you're God probably right.
This man who is obviously pro-homosexual.
Obviously pro-homosexual.
Shaken up a large 2-liter bottle of soda and opened it up and ran from behind us. He began to spray us.
What a prankster.
Got it all over our clothes.
Yeah, that's pretty rude, but he's jogging at the same time, so he's getting his exercise in there.
Campaigning for traditional marriage.
Well, I was standing on the side of the street, and I had a camera. My sole purpose was to just keep an eye out for any trouble.
So he's like the bodyguard of
that a car
FTP or TFP.
Could have made it through a green light, slowed down,
and the passenger stuck his arm out of his window and sprayed pesticide at me.
Whoa, he had that prepared?
Just start taking pictures as soon as the car started passing. I was getting sprayed as well, the pesticide, stained my clothes, and stained the black plastic on the camera as well.
What would have hit my face,
that sucks.
Hit the front of the sign. But he did manage to get some of it on my hands, which had a burning sensation for 2 hours afterwards.
Yikes.
So when the policeman asked if
yeah,
we had
that,
gotten
that's
pictures,
pretty crazy.
We were able to show him all these pictures, and the policeman just started chuckling because he said this is everything that we need to find these people and to show that what they had done.
Pause. Yeah, the pesticide incident, definitely scary. I would have to agree. That's like, you know, that's prepared. I mean, who carries pesticide in their car? This is a tradition, like civilian Honda car. It doesn't look like a farm car or anything, but yeah, that is like premeditated prank attack. And that really sucks that, you know, pesticide, it stings. I'm really glad he didn't get hurt, because if it got in his eyes, that would be horrible. If the police did track him down, I have to wonder, like, what kind of punishment would... I can't imagine the sentence being extremely harsh. It'd probably be like a fine or something. But, you know, I would have to... I do wonder about, like, the follow-up of the police authority. Continuing in 3, 2, 1, play.
Campus at Berkeley, and a couple of us were standing holding our banners there. One of the students, a young lady, she started burning our flyer, our literature that we were handing out.
And then she continued kneeling there as if saying a prayer of some type.
How can you have a discussion with someone when they take your flyer and burn it? Somebody else, another student, grabbed our
We're not
box
looking for
flyers,
a discussion, but.
About 1,200 flyers or something. They burnt them in another area of the campus, and the police showed up. The fire truck and everything.
Wow,
but
that's pretty serious.
It was so apparent that these guys don't practice tolerance. They don't practice what they preach at all. The aggressiveness that was there is something where, you know, you have to be there. If somebody doubts, you know, if somebody thinks we're exaggerating.
No, I don't doubt your exaggeration.
I would like recommend that they would come and join us.
I take your word for it. But, like, here's the thing. Pause. Here's the thing. So this incident that happened in this University of Arizona, I can see it upsetting you, you know. Somebody takes your flyer, and that person takes a few steps or squats down right in front of you and starts burning that flyer in front of you. Yeah, that's upsetting. Is it an attack? To a degree, it's not. I think it's perfectly... I think it's okay. I think it's legal, at least. And it's not really an attack. It's just really rude and probably offensive to you. You were probably really offended by this, which is understandable. But I mean, it's still protect that would still be protected under, you know, First Amendment, freedom of speech and whatnot, to be able to burn a flyer right in front of you. The only issue that I would have with this is if it does cause harm around you, if it causes fire and damages property, if it causes a fire and hurts someone, that's definitely something that they can be prosecuted for. And that's definitely something that's just not cool. It shouldn't be allowed. But, like, somebody accepting the flyer in front of you, squatting down in front of you, and burning that thing, that person is making a statement. That person is definitely being, not agreeing with you. And it's not a discussion. That person doesn't want to have an open-minded discussion with you. That person just wants to make a statement that person disagrees with you. I think that's actually perfectly okay. I don't see a problem with this. So, yeah, that's my opinion anyway. Continuing on, and 3, 2, 1, play.
This is because it's very real, and you'll see it if you go.
As we were walking, we noticed a car pulled up and stopped right along the curb.
What about people that just want to be happy?
He's labeled an attacker. Somebody just starts yelling at.
Started yelling at us, all sorts of profanities, and at a certain point, he got
that sucks, but so far, no problem.
Just ran around his car at us, came right up into our face, to my face, and then at a certain point, he just shoved me.
Okay, that's definitely problematic. I
fell backwards. I didn't fall down, but
I mean, up to the point where he gets close to you and pushes you, that's probably the problem part. But I don't like how this guy, I don't like how this guy is labeled as a pro-homosexual activist. This guy is, like, that's an assumption. Maybe he is a gay rights activist. Maybe. But he stopped his car, was offended, started yelling profanity at the volunteers, came really close to someone's face and pushed that person. Clearly, this is a guy who is offended by this whole traditional marriage protesting. So perhaps it's pretty obvious to assume that he is for gay rights and for gay marriage. But to automatically label him as a pro-homosexual activist is wrong. That's an overly generalized statement, which makes this documentary feel more like a propaganda than an actual documentary. That's just saying. Alright, continuing in 3, 2, 1, play. So this is now Brown University. Wow, there's a group of people. Gay rights protester simply glory. This is the mob of people chanting, "Never come back." Yeah. That's pretty frightening. I mean, but that's freedom of the assembly.
Did somebody just spit in your face?
Yes, sir.
Right. Who's face? Who spit in your face?
A man. I could recognize him if I saw him.
Did he say anything?
No, I offered him a flyer. And he said, he just spat at me.
The spit landed directly on my face, pretty much all over my forehead.
That sucks.
My eyebrows, except for my eyes. Luckily, they gave my eyes.
I took my handkerchief out and wiped it away. He just spit on him and immediately took off, immediately walked away. Quick as you could. It's not the first time, you know. I was spit on at another intersection we did.
What are you talking about?
You
open-mindedness.
Yeah, whatever.
If you want an open-minded discussion.
And it's very quick, but it's revolting, and it shows the lack of tolerance. It shows a lot of things. The person they don't have an argument. They don't have, you know, they disagree with you, but like a child or like someone with no self-control. They just do what comes to them. It's a reaction.
So pause. I like how he's like, the guy, the volunteer, it's like they don't have an argument. You know, they don't want to have this open-minded discussion. I understand his frustration. But here's the thing. Like, do you really expect an open-minded discussion by going out in the streets with the sign? That's not even canvassing. That's just kind of protesting. If you want an open-minded, since, I don't know, your position is not tolerant, but if you want an open-minded discussion, this is not the way to do it. You know, even canvassing is not the way to do it. I mean, I've had open-minded discussion, as a canvasser, but it's not even the method. Canvassing is to fundraise, for the most part, or to get someone elected. This, I don't even know the purpose here. The purpose is just to get your message across and to have people honk at you if they agree or not. This is not a method to encourage discussion. So I don't know why you're not surprised that people are not coming up to you and saying like, "Oh yeah, I disagree with you, but I want to have an open-minded debate with you because I don't agree with your position." No, people like me who likes to have debate, if I see a bunch of people, you know, holding up signs that are like, "God's marriage equals one woman and one man," you know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to walk past you and ignore you because that is not, like, I don't want to have debate with you guys holding signs, like, I don't care. So it's either going to be people who just walk away, people who honk because they agree with you, or, unfortunately, these kinds of people that do get really offended and approach you guys and you know, at hopefully they just yell at you and say, I don't agree with you, whatever. But in some cases, unfortunately, like these, people do get really offended to the point where, you know, they do things that are really rude and not cool. All right, continuing in 3, 2, 1, play.
Yeah, after it happened, I wasn't going to give up. I just kept on doing it. I kept on handing out flyers.
Wow. Yeah, Brazilians, my friend.
He was the youngest volunteer, and that's why they picked on.
So it was just a normal campaign, and for no reason, this young man came up, and he had a Bible in his hand, and he started ripping out pages and throwing them into the faces of the two members.
Sorry. That's pretty funny.
Your Bible.
He is littering. That's true, actually.
A piece of Bible at a TIF member, you would insult the Catholic Church.
He just has a Bible. He's walking back and forth, and he's just ripping out pages.
Exactly. Well, then why are you cute guys?
Why are you fucking in a voice?
So while this was going on, two other men came. One of them was holding a rainbow flag, and he says, I'm glad he's ripping up the Bible. I smoked a joint with the Bible.
That's pretty funny. Smoke a joint with the Bible. That's, I understand why, you know, TFP would be highly offended, but like, I don't see a problem with any of that. That's just freedom of press right there. Or freedom of assembly and freedom of speech. Now that right there, that's somebody just came out.
So he jumped up.
It was in slow motion too. I like how these guys, these documentaries like to use slow motion.
Started shouting aggressor at him while he was ripping up the banner.
Just comes out and grabs one of the signs and banners and just starts ripping it apart.
He ripped the banner into several pieces and then just threw it on the ground and walked across the crosswalk again. The other side of the corner.
Hey, that's not cool. You know, that's not cool.
Debate beforehand. He didn't address us beforehand. He comes across.
Again, this is not the way to have a debate. Yeah. But, yeah.
Where is the tolerance there? Where is the intellectual process? If you disagree with something, you know, you address it with the person. We're just standing on the street.
Well, he addressed it, but the way he addressed it was definitely not cool.
And, you know, he disagrees, so he just attacks us. Is that how tolerance works?
No, that is not how tolerance works, but...
Said, are you going to give me that sign, or am I going to have to rip it out of your hands?
That guy's an asshole.
This is a beer bottle.
The bottle is thrown at an FTP volunteer. Or TFP. I get that abbreviation wrong.
From oncoming traffic.
It's a beer bottle. They threw it out of the car.
That's assault.
Wait a minute.
That's assault.
No, it's a different one.
Getting thrown out of a car.
He has a big bump on his head there. Right, that's here. Crazy.
I saw the big lump on his head.
Yeah.
It was pretty big. It looked like it hurt.
So there's about 7 of us in York and Penny in Warwick Mall. We were getting good support, a lot of honks. A few things thrown at us. One of them was a car. It threw a water bottle and, you know, went away screaming. About 10 minutes later, we saw the car come back and pull into the Dunkin' Donuts, so we were sort of prepared to what's...
That's not a good sign, yeah. If somebody's coming back. What's he doing? Whoa. They're like, I can't. This is like one of those Batman Begins fighting sequences. I can't even see what's going on.
We saw that this is not going to be a friendly confrontation.
Yeah, I mean...
Do people think you are... Yeah, take a picture. What are you doing?
Hey, I'm glad that they've respected people's privacy and just kind of blurred out their faces, so their confidentiality is maintained.
Away from us, I went forward to try to help the cameraman because he was in the middle of all of this attack.
That's what gay people.
Cameraman actually.
Oh wow! So this is actually like a physical assault right here.
So as soon as I approached, one of the women started spraying me in the face with mace.
God dang.
Get away.
I mean,
get away from us.
Get away from us.
Get away from us.
Go, police.
Go, police.
Go, police.
Go, police.
People always do that though. Like, pause. So there was one time where, like, I don't know, maybe I was in, you know, I was a canvasser. I knocked on somebody's door, and I'm doing the exact opposite of what these guys are doing, because I was canvassing for the Human Rights Campaign, which is the nation's largest LGBT civil rights group. We weren't campaigning for gay marriage. We were campaigning for something else, some other legislation that is for gay rights. But yeah, I mean, this guy that I knocked on the door, I mean, he's for gay equality. He just didn't like the fact that I was knocking on his door. So, you know, he was really upset. He's like, you know, I was like, I'm going to call the police. Like, call the police. I'm like, okay, fine, sir. You know, we have the, you know, our group, our canvassing organization has, every right to be here. We already contacted the local city police. They know we're here. They know us by names. You know, whatever. He's just like, I'm still going to call the police. Like, okay, fine. I mean, and I had a lovely chat with the police officer that came. But, like, it's really interesting that in this situation, you know, the TFP group is, I'm calling the police. And then the people who kind of were attacking or got involved in this kind of shuffle was like, fine, call the police. I don't care. Call the police. Like, they were like, they're so agitated. This is really interesting to see. I don't know. I just wanted to say that. All right, let's continue. 3, 2, 1, and play.
When the police finally found him, their first defense was that they went there to have a friendly conversation. A friendly discussion.
And of course, they would lie and defend the themselves.
That as soon as they crossed the street, the first thing out of their mouth was...
What I, of course, immediately heard was our people yelling, aggression, aggression. So by the time I was able to make it to the median, the assailants had already left, but the signs of the attack were quite visible. So poor Rex, and I can remember Wilts got hit by pepper spray. Their faces were red, their eyes were bloodshot, stinging. You could tell they had difficulty seeing.
Yeah, I've never been attacked by mace before, but I would imagine that really hurt.
During a campaign in Augusta, Maine, and in the afternoon rush, and though I was a bit distant from a few of the others, a few of my colleagues did witness a Toyota truck jumping the curb and would have hit me if I had not moved out of the way.
These people wearing masks covering their face.
Whoa. That's interesting.
Came up and stood in front of our banner. They were screaming all sorts of blasphemies, trying to provoke us. And one thing they screamed was, God is dead. God is dead.
God is dead!
That's what
God is dead! God is dead! God is dead! God is dead!
I don't even know what to think about all this. This is crazy.
And their response to us praying the rosary.
So pause. That's interesting. So so this group of people come in with masks on. There's one person going, God is dead, God is dead, which to this group in particular is a highly offensive thing to say. I mean, I don't see anything wrong with that statement personally. But I mean, just this is totally a provocation there. And then this group comes. It's a very small group, just like the TFP volunteer group. And then there's one, I noticed in this one picture, there's a person holding up the site, I support gay marriage. That's one of the signs. It's even cruder than the TFP sign, because the handwriting is not as good. But I support gay marriage, that person's there. I mean, like, honestly, like, I don't see... I wouldn't consider this an attack. I don't see this as a huge problem, but I mean, it is kind of, you know, it sucks to be them. That's really all I have to say. It sucks to be them, to have this group of people close to you and saying, you know, and protesting exactly the opposite message of your traditional message. Traditional message. Traditional marriage. The opposite message for gay marriage. And then there's these two groups together now that are kind of like protesting the exact opposite things. This happens sometimes. I've actually seen this happen one time in California. It was about the Iraq War, but there was like a group of people who were like, support the troops, and then the group of people who are like, you know, holding up the sign like, bring the troops back home. And then there's two groups of people who are like really close together, really like one, I think, I don't know, I guess it's like a similar situation here where the conservative group is kind of like just baffled. And then the liberal group, you know, bring the troops home, or in this case, I support gay marriage group, are like really fiercely animated. So honestly, like, it sucks for the TFP, but like it's nothing's happening right now. So at this point, I'm okay with it. But I mean, like, this is what happened. Like, I don't think this is something to be surprised of or to be shocked by. But yeah, let's continue in 3, 2, 1, and play.
One blasphemy after another.
One blasphemy after another. Wow. Wow, that's a huge group, actually. That's bigger than the group of TFP. Damn, they're really into it.
I've been doing campaigns for the TFP for decades.
Decades?
A variety of issues.
Decades?
I have never seen more egregious examples of intolerance than the reactions of homosexual activists on these cases.
Homosexual activists. Well, I guess those people can be considered activists because they actually do have signs and stuff, but
spoken debate, the debate of the word. And that was pretty clear to all of us that they did not like the reaction we were arousing in the public.
Pause. Okay, so, like, this guy talks about, I guess this seems like one of the head guys. He seems like one of the moderators or one of the leaders of TFP. He seems official. He's done this for decades. That's pretty amazing. And he's just like, look, I've done this for, the gist of what he said was like, I've done this for so long, and never before have I seen this group of homosexual activists. They're the most egregious of, you know, of intolerance that I've ever seen. One point I want to make is 20 years ago, 30 years ago, or even 10 years ago, you're right, the LGBT community was not like this animated or this crazy, you know, and whatever, because back in those days, if they did that, you know, it still happens today, but it was more frequent 10 years ago or 20 years ago that somebody who is openly gay might get beat up, might, you know, actually get raped, might get, you know, like, get assaulted, and might get murdered. It was much more frequent then, so it was much of a scarier time to be openly gay in the past than it is now. Nowadays, I mean, there is still an issue of bullying, assault, rape, and all that kind of thing, and abuse and violence towards LGBT people, but it's not as accepted by society as it was then. So that's probably one of the main reasons why, I mean, you noticed this difference from a decade ago of campaigning and now campaigning. I don't know, that's just a thought. I could be totally wrong on that, but that's just one of the thoughts I had. Pretty amazing that you've been campaigning for traditional marriage for decades. Props to you, I guess. Props to you. Sure. All right, continuing in 3, 2, 1, and play.
So they wanted to try to do their best to stop it, and the only resort they had was violence.
Now the pictures of angry people flipping them off. This is fun. Guy throws a water bottle, yells. This is like a summary footage of everything that happened. I don't know, I mean, people flipping you off, like, what are you gonna do? But yeah, some of these pranks, and like, they're not pranks, because they're really, like, they're assault sometimes, you know, like, I don't know, that I found that funny, person throwing ripping out the pages of the Bible and insulting the Catholic Church, funny stuff, but throwing the beer bottle, definitely assault. That was not cool. Pushing someone, not cool. Pepper spray, pesticide, not cool. I mean, there are definitely examples of assault and attack here, but I feel like most of them are something I wouldn't even, you know, consider as attacks. definitely offensive if I was part of the group that believed that, if I believed in what they believed, some of the stuff would be upsetting and offensive, but and just because they're upset and offensive doesn't mean it's not protected by the First Amendment, which in many of these cases, except for the assaults, the actual assaults, they are protected by the First Amendment. So that's the red flag there. I don't know what the red flag is. Oh, so it gets patriotic in the end of the video. America!
In over 31 America. States, Americans have said, no, we don't want marriage to change.
That means that the majority of Americans don't want same-sex marriage.
This issue is attacking us, our beliefs, and we should stand up for what is right.
Yeah, I don't like the majority argument here. If majority of people wanted black people as slaves,
we know what marriage is. We know how God intended it to be. And we don't want counterfeits. I think more Americans need to wake up and see that the type of tolerance that the homosexual movement preaches is just a big lie.
Such a generalization. You can't generalize the homosexual movement out of these examples of violent attacks.
And so then
a lot of which are not actually violent attacks.
It doesn't deter us. It doesn't stop us.
It really shows how
important. Of course it wouldn't.
And how really necessary this fight for traditional marriage really is. More than ever, we're going to go to more cities, more states, more college campuses to defend traditional marriage.
Well, we know God's law. We're there to defend His law.
The more the homosexual movement attacks traditional marriage, the more we'll be ready to defend it. If you think that we're going to give up because of some petty attack, well, you're wrong. We're never going to give up.
Right, I would agree, actually, that would embolden you guys more.
We're not.
If we did those type of...
We're ready to go. At a moment's notice, we're there.
We're not gonna.
Are you guys Superman? We're ready to go. At a moment's notice, we're ready to go. Fired up. That's so funny. Yeah.
Will CNN and MSNBC run this footage? Probably not. So please share with your friends.
With your friends. And God bless. I think that's. There's like 30 more seconds left. I don't know if this is something I want to keep watching. May God protect America from the homosexual agenda. There's that lion symbol. The American Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, Property, www.tfp.org. TFP Student Action, www.tfpstudentaction.org. So yeah, if you like these guys' messages and if you like this documentary, I guess... check them out and even email them. They even left out an email address there. But yeah, that's the video. Like I said, this video, I expected it to be like a really long video. I'm surprised it's actually only 33 minutes long. It's been a long video. But I just thought that was an interesting one to react to. It is from a group, this group of volunteers, which is the name of the organization, I keep forgetting. I'm going to have to look at this. The name of the organization, American Society for Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property. And I like their abbreviation because it's short, TFP. This is a group that I am totally, totally not agreeing with because I am pro-gay rights. I am pro-gay marriage. I think this was a really important and interesting video to watch simply because, I know, I've been a canvasser before, so being out there in the street and... they're not canvassing, but I guess it's kind of similar. They're holding up a sign and just standing there for almost the entire day for their cause, which, I don't agree with their cause, but, the shit they deal with, I think, is definitely unfortunate. But I don't get the point of it, other than to kind of get the message across that they're for traditional marriage. And it serves no other purpose, really. Canvassing is fundraising and getting the message across. This is just kind of just there, it's just kind of a protesting. Protesting, I think is an important thing, but the group is too small to actually make a big protest difference. If you wanted a protest or a rally, I feel like it should be bigger, because when you have a mob or a huge group of people, it's safer. First of all, there's less likelihood of a pair of individuals coming to you and attacking you, because there's a huge group, you know, that protects you. So I guess my advice to TFP is to grow. I would hate for them to grow, but I guess to be safe, try to go out with the biggest group as possible to be safe. But to expect, again, this is my second and final point before I end this video. To expect an open-ended debate or discussion out of this is kind of, in my opinion, stupid. Because you're just protesting. You're not out there to have an open discussion. If you wanted an open discussion, this is not the way to do it. I guess it would be kind of like maybe have, you know, a single person or one person out there watching. So have like two or three people there, and one person will just kind of approach people and just like, hey, how's it going? My name is such and such. What do you think about this? We are TFP, and you know, we are for traditional marriage, and we want to enlighten you on blah blah blah. Kind of just doing that, which is kind of like canvassing, but not really, because it's kind of like it. But that method, it's much better than just standing out as a group of people and holding up a sign saying "honk" for traditional marriage. Like, that seems kind of pointless. I wonder how this group is funded. Like, is it just a group of volunteers who think that doing this is fun and doing this is effective? Because there's certainly more effective ways to get to fight for a cause than standing there with signs. I don't really see the effectiveness of this campaign. But I mean, that's just my opinion. I think there are much better ways to get to fight for a campaign. Even if I believed in traditional marriage, I wouldn't agree to be a volunteer for this, because it's boring, it's dangerous, because people are going to attack me, and it's not effective. But anyway, those are my reactions to this video. It's a long video, it's about 18 minutes long, just like how this video is about 37 minutes long. But yeah, those are my thoughts. Hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.